Gentlemen, and welcome to Studio Art. I, as always, am your instructor, Mr. Schwartz, and in today's lesson, we're going to learn about linear perspective and how to make all of your shapes and your forms and everything that you draw apply to this law. The law of perspective states that whatever is closest to you is largest, and as it goes back into space and gets further away from you, it gets smaller and more narrow. The reason why artists apply this to their drawings is because it gives them the ability to create a three-dimensional space on a two-dimensional plane. Also, objects that conform to the laws of perspective look more realistic, as that's the way things look in the real world. So before we get started, we're going to take a look at some key terms, and then I'll show you how those terms are applied in a one-point perspective drawing. So let's get to it. Okay, so these are our key terms, and they're going to be referred to over and over again during all of the perspective lessons, and there's going to be a couple of them. So linear perspective is a system of creating an illusion of depth on a flat surface, and that's what we're doing as artists. We're reflecting the natural world around us, and we're creating the illusion of that world on a surface. So when we were doing the shading unit, we were creating the illusion of light and shadow. And in this, we're creating the illusion of depth and three-dimensionality and three-dimensional space on a flat surface. All parallel lines in a linear perspective drawing, in a painting or drawing, converge to a single vanishing point on the composition's horizon line. Okay, so few things there. We're going to break down all of those words in the following vocabulary words. So it mentioned converging lines, it mentioned horizon line, and it mentioned vanishing point. So horizon line in almost all representational landscape drawings or paintings of a place, it contains a horizontal line that runs across the paper or canvas, and this represents the viewer's eye level or shows where the sky and the land meet. In some cases, it might be like a desk and a wall, but it basically divides the picture plane into bottom and top. Is where the person's view is as well. So if you wanted to make something that appeared underwater, your horizon line would be very, very high. And then if you wanted something to appear like you're in the sky, your horizon line would be low. And if it wanted to appear that you're on the land, it would be about halfway. Converging lines are all lines that start in different places and all come together at a single point. The point at which they come together in a one-point perspective drawing is the vanishing point. The vanishing point represents the furthest distance away from the viewer. It's a distance so far away that you can no longer see anything at all. It's where sight disappears. So all lines start out very close, and then they converge and get smaller to a single point and come together. So let's take a look at how this is applied in an actual one-point perspective drawing. Okay, here we have a one-point perspective drawing. This line here, okay, that separates the top from the bottom is our horizon line. So this is the eye level of the person either walking. It's basically the eye level of somebody who is standing and walking through this alley. Okay, so the point right here where my arrow is the vanishing point. And if we were to take any line here, they actually go all to the same exact point. So the idea is that you take a geometric shape like this rectangle here, and you go from the corners of that shape back to the vanishing point using a ruler, and then you make a parallel line from, let's just say, this bottom horizontal line you would make here to shore up the back of it. So you have the same lines in the front and the back, and all of the side lines are diagonal converging lines. So front lines are always straight, side lines are always converging and diagonal. Okay, so we covered horizon line, we covered vanishing point, we covered converging lines, how all of these lines here start at different places, but they all meet here. And yes, this is linear perspective. The artist also made this can here, like much bigger than, let's just say, this pipe. It's not to say that this pipe isn't bigger than this, but it's making a point of creating distance by making some things smaller that are behind others and some things bigger that are in front. So studying this drawing, there's a lot that you can learn, all right? But again, I just want to reiterate that things start from a regular geometric shape like a rectangle, and from the corners facing the vanishing point, they all go back to the vanishing point. Okay, so that's how that's done. Okay, why is perspective used? I went over this in the introduction, but let's go over it again. This is a very historic example of perspective here. This is the horizon line, the vanishing point, somewhere in the center, and all lines are converging to that single point here. All right, linear perspective uses principles of math to realistically portray space and depth in art. Renaissance artists were largely concerned with painting realistic scenes, and linear perspective gave them a reliable method to accomplish this realism, which helped make their paintings all the more captivating. So there was a time before artists applied perspective, and once they did, it had the ability, because all the lines are going inwards, of bringing the viewer into the space of the artwork, and that was revolutionary at the time. We're now gonna watch a video on one-point perspective. Unfortunately, there won't be any, it won't have the narrator's voice on it, but I've attached the video to the Google Classroom assignment, and you can go back and check it out there. But you should get the idea of how simple one-point perspective is applied to a geometric shape such as a rectangle or a triangle or a circle. And so we're going to watch this video, and then after the video, we're going to switch back, and I'm going to talk about what your assignments are. Okay, so I'll see you after the video. Oh, Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was our video, and here we are at our first assignment. So we always, as a rule, start out very simply with just geometric shapes, and then we move on to more complex things. So what I'm gonna have you do is practice just making simple shapes. You're gonna make four geometric shapes, and you're gonna put the vanishing point in the center and have them all the edges of those shapes going back towards the vanishing point. Okay, so the way that is going to happen is you're going to take a single sheet of paper, you can fold it in half both ways so you have four sections, outline the creases. So you want four equal sections on a sheet. On the instruction where it says draw a shape around the center of each of the four sections, that might be a little confusing. What I mean by that is draw a shape in the center, somewhere in the center of each of the four shapes, okay? And try to do a minimum of two different shapes or four different shapes to really challenge yourself. Okay, so at the cross section of the vertical and horizontal lines of the page, you're going to put your vanishing point right there. and you're going to demonstrate how you take the edges of the shape closest to the vanishing point and how you make them converge to a single point. And then also how you use parallel lines to create the back end of that shape. Finally, what you want to do is you want to erase the converging lines, any converging lines that are not needed anymore, and outline with ink the main 3D form that you're left with after the whole drawing process is done. Okay, so in addition to drawing each of the four shapes correctly, you are then going to take a second step by identifying a different light source for each of the shapes. Okay, so this is exactly like the basic shading from a light source assignment, where you had geometric shapes and you identified the light source and you shaded accordingly. This is going to be the same thing, only you're the one creating three-dimensional forms. All right. One thing to take into account is that now that there are different sides, each side is going to be shaded in a different way. So just a hint of how that might be done. The side that is on the opposite side of where the light source is should be the darkest, because that's the furthest away. But then again, depending on what you feel is right, you're going to assign each of the sides a darker, a middle, or a darkest, like three shades of dark, okay, or light, depending on where the light's hitting, okay? So don't make each side exactly the same. Differentiate them somehow, even if they're all in shadow, if that makes sense. I hope that makes sense, okay? So just to summarize, you're going to take a piece of paper, divide it into four sections, draw a simple shape in each of the four sections, put your vanishing point in the middle, make the converging lines, make the completed three-dimensional shape, erase any unnecessary lines, ink the final three-dimensional shape, and then I want you to identify a different light source for each three-dimensional form, and shade it accordingly. Okay, you have all that? So that is the first assignment. Okay, well, that's the only assignment for this, all right? All right, so for this, the materials you're gonna need a ruler, pencil, ink, and an eraser. Okay, so that's all for this assignment. If there's any follow-up questions, you can be sure to find me at office hours. I'll see you at the next assignment. Until then, take care.